You create configurable consolidation rules on the Consolidated tab of the Consolidation Process page. You create rules within rulesets. Configurable consolidation rules run during consolidation and create consolidation accounting entries using the elimination member of the consolidation dimension. I'll add a rule to the equity adjustments for subsidiaries ruleset. The rules in this ruleset are used to eliminate the subsidiary's consolidation amount from equity accounts, post an offset for the subsidiary's percentage ownership to the goodwill account, and post the minority interest ownership share to the minority interest account. The rules in a ruleset typically create a balanced set of entries in the chart of accounts. I'll add a rule to calculate minority interest. To add a rule to a ruleset, select the row for the ruleset, and then click Create Rule. Enter a name and description. Rules may inherit conditions from the ruleset. You cannot override ruleset conditions for individual rules. For this ruleset, the consolidation method must be subsidiary, and the data value cannot be zero. The factor is the percentage applied to the source value to calculate the amount to post to the elimination member. I'll use the current period minority interest ownership percentage as the factor. If a factor was defined in the rule set, it is used by all rules in the rule set, and this field is read-only. The processing option specifies whether the source value should be added to or subtracted from the target. If the source and target account types are different, account intelligence determines whether to reverse the sign in addition to performing the specified add or subtract. The dataset and scope settings are inherited from the rule set. The dataset specifies the members from which to retrieve the data. The scope allows the dataset to be filtered to limit the members for which the rule executes. You cannot modify the dataset or scope in the individual rules. You can redirect source members of the account, intercompany, movement, data source, or custom dimensions to a different target member. I'll select minority interest for the target account. You can only select a single base level member for the target. If there are multiple source members, the values are accumulated in the target. In this case, values for equity accounts that meet the filter criteria will accumulate in the minority interest account. You can add condition blocks for the redirection members. For intercompany, if the current source entity is a base level member, I want to post to its intercompany member. For movement, if the data represents an acquisition by the holding company, I want to post to acquisitions, otherwise to disposals. I'll add a condition block to intercompany with the legal company consolidation string in the statement. This returns true if the entity is a base member. Consolidation strings are useful consolidation functions and are available for the entity and intercompany dimensions. I'll use the consolidation string source POV entity to specify the redirection member. This string is replaced with the current source entity member at runtime. I'll leave the else member at the default of same as source. For the movement condition block, if the change in ownership percentage is an increase, select acquisitions as the target member. Otherwise, select disposals. Typically, the data source member is redirected to a level 0 member under total eliminations. You can add custom members under total eliminations to provide a ruleset by ruleset audit trail. I have added a member named Equity Adjustments to track the results from this ruleset. I am finished working on this rule, so I'll click Save and Close. The rule has been added to the ruleset. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.